السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. On behalf of Markaz Sahaba, the voice of Ahlu Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we present to you lesson number 1913 of our daily Nasiha and advice. Today, with the grace and mercy of Almighty Allah Jalla Wala, we focus on the 18th of Rajab. It was on the 18th of Rajab, the year 256 after Hijrah, corresponding to 21st of June 870 Gregorian calendar, the Abbasid Khalifa Muhammad al-Muhtadi bin Harun Rashid, meaning Harun Rashid's son, he departed this temporary world. He was the 14th Khalifa of the Abbasid dynasty. We mentioned to you that in total there were 37 Khulafa and their rule was for 520 plus years. But his rule was very, very short and not even a year, as he was removed from power and 4 days after that he passed away after his removal. So remember that sometimes there was political conflict within themselves, sometimes there was politics among themselves. All that said and done, we look at the Quran Sharif, تُؤْتِ الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتَنْزِعُ الْمُلْكَ مِمَّنْ تَشَاءُ. Allah Jalla Allah gives sovereignty, power to whomsoever He wishes and snatches it away from whomsoever He wishes. وَتُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتُذِلُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ. Allah gives honor to whoever He wishes. Allah disgraces whoever He wishes. How many a king, how many a prime minister, president, ruler were ruling and then they had to resign, or they were incapacitated, or there was, you must remember, elections and they lost and so forth. So all this we see in our own eyes, in our own life. So that is the what Quran Sharif is teaching us. And then death, kullu nafsin zaikatul maut, every living being shall taste death. We as Muslims, three du'as we should be making. That number one, Surah 12, verse 101, Surah Yusuf, Surah chapter 12, verse 101, Tawaffani muslima wa alihiqni bis salihin. O beloved Allah, let me pass away with Iman and Islam and unite me with the pious people. And then number two, remember, Allahumma inni ala sakaratil maut. Ya Allah, you assist me against the pains and the pangs of death. So these are reality. Quran Kareem states, waja'at sakratul maut bil haqq. And then Allahumma barik li fil maut, Allahumma barik lana fil maut, Allahumma barik li, Ya Allah, give me barakat and blessing at the time of death. And Allahumma barik lana for all of us, Allahumma barik lana fil maut wa fi ma ba'd al maut, meaning Ya Allah, give us barakah, make everything easy, and we pass away with Iman. That is the greatest concern for us as Muslims. Similarly, when we go to the pages of history, then we see that it was the 18th of Rajab and the year 1012, and that is Gregorian calendar, 22nd December 1603, and this was the death of Muhammad III of the Ottoman Sultan. So, you know, they would call them Sultan and so forth. So again, we see death striking. Aynama takunu yudrikkumul mautu walau kuntum fi burujim mushayyada. Remember, wherever you are, death will reach you. Even you in the lofty, lofty towers and palaces or wherever else. Or innal maut alladhi tafirruna min, the death which you are running away from, fa innahu mulaqikum, then surely it will reach you. So no person can escape death. Almighty Allah addressing the best of the best, Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alaihi wasallam, saying, innaka mayyitu wa innahum mayyitun, that you, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, your demise will take place and they also will pass away. So therefore for us, read Surah chapter 3 verse 8, 8, ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة. Ya Allah, do not let our hearts get deviated after you gave us the guidance, and grant us from your side, Ya Allah, the special mercy to envelop us. Innaka antal wahhab, Ya Allah, you are the best of giver. So in that way, Almighty Allah Jalla wala, accept all our humble efforts and make our khatima on iman. Ya Rabbal Alameen, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.